yo estoy aquí para enseñar a ustedes esto. Los morenos, los latinos, los indios nativos. Sí, yo, tú, el que está apuntando para acá, sí. Nosotros estamos aquí para enseñarle a ustedes que ustedes son la gente elegida de Dios. Los morenos, los latinos, los indios nativos. Yeah, us. We're here to teach you. Estamos aquí para enseñarle a ustedes. Ahora, no es nada nuevo. Hoy es el sábado. Hoy no se puede vender joyería, no se puede vender pizza, no se puede vender coquito, no se puede vender nada de estas cosas. Sorry. Pero ustedes siguen haciendo lo mismo.
Éxodo, capítulo 20, versículo 8. Ustedes creen que esto es un juego. Esto no es un juego. Acuérdate del día de reposo.
Hoy es el día de reposo. El séptimo día que Dios dirigió para nosotros, para descansar, no para trabajar, no para romper los mandamientos. Pero no, como tú crees que tú tienes más edad que yo, tú crees que tú sabes más que yo, o tú crees que tú sabes más que Dios, o tú quieres hacer lo que te da la gana. No, yo estoy hablando en general, porque no es solamente él, sino toda nuestra gente que creen que son más que Dios. Lee otra vez.
Acuérdate del día de reposo para santificarlo. Seis días trabajarás.
Tú tienes seis días para hacer lo que te da la gana. Tú tienes seis días para hacer lo que te da la gana. You have 6 days to do whatever you want. Read it in English.
Remember the seventh day to keep holy.
Today is the seventh day, the Sabbath day. I'm going to speak in English and I'm going to speak in Spanish. You understand? Because we're in Harlem. We're in Spanish Harlem, so-called. You know what I'm saying? But these things that our people don't want to understand and they don't want to do because they are rebellious as all hell. Read it again.
Remember the seventh day.
You, brother, are an Israelite according to the Bible. You see the sign right here? What's your nationality according to this Bible? According to this sign right here. All right, you're Puerto Rican. Can I talk to you for a second? Puerto Riches. You have nothing that you have no idea what God wants to say. What's your nationality according to this?
First one.
You're Judah. Okay, you say you're Puerto Rican. Hold on. Let me tell you something.
First of all, I came here quietly. Well, listen, we're here.
Isaiah 58:1. We don't come here quiet. We do not come here quiet. Read that.
Respectively, I read your material and I walked away respectively. And you all know that, but you're with me.
Read that. Cry aloud. We are here to cry aloud. We are not to come here and speak quiet. We are not going to spare any one of you rebellious people's feelings.
Like that boy, like a trumpet.
We are going to lift our voice like a trumpet.
And so my people, their transgression.
And I'm supposed to show God's people your sins. That is it. We're not here to play no games with nobody. I don't care how old you are. I don't care how young you are. We're going to do God's work, and that is it.
Yes, really.
Either you like it or you don't. Either way, I don't care. God wants you to do what he wants. I'm supposed to send the message to you. I don't care if you like it or not. I'm the messenger. My brothers here are messengers. Read it again.
Cry aloud!
We are supposed to cry aloud. Are you supposed to hear me if I'm talking like this? Can you hear me, brother? You know that God... Are you comfortable with that? No! Do you want me to tell you that God is going to kill you if you don't keep his commandments? Do you really believe me? Do you believe that the Bible really says that? If I talk like this? Brother, you need to change. The hell is that? No, the Bible says what?
Cry aloud.
We're supposed to cry aloud. Speak like a man. Like Christ spoke. Like a man. His voice, the Bible says that his voice was like the voice of many waters. Meaning that it echoed. like Niagara Falls. Rough. You can hear it for miles. Get on.
Isaiah 58 verse 1. Cry aloud. It's fair not.
I'm not supposed to feel sorry for you in terms of, okay, well, you know, I got a broken whatever. Listen. Fix it and keep God's commandments. That's it. Whatever problems you have, resolve it. But you still got to keep God's commandments. That's it. That's how we spare not. You understand? Now, before you leave, I got to show you your sin. Because it says right there that we have to spare not and show my people their transgressions. That's what God said. So I got to show you your transgressions, bro. Now you have somewhat of a beard, but I can tell that you're accustomed by shaving your beard off, yes?
Leviticus capítulo 19:27. Ye shall not around the corner of your hair.
You're not supposed to round the corners of your head. You're not supposed to shave your head bald. You don't do that, I can tell. However,
neither shalt thou mark the corner of thy beard.
You're not supposed to shave your beard bald. As the brother spoke earlier, he said there's a difference between a man and a boy. The reason why men grow beards and women and children don't is because the beard is a badge of manly dignity. Kings used to wear their beards. Some kings still do, because there's some kings around. But our people are kings. We just don't act like them. We don't recognize them. You're a king. But the Bible says you're not supposed to shave or mar or destroy the corners of your beard. Why? Why does God say that we have to wear beards, doesn't it? You know why? Read the first verse of that chapter. I'll tell you.
Leviticus chapter 18, verse 1. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, and speak unto the children of Israel.
You are one of the children of the Most High God. You're the children of Israel. Go ahead.
And say unto them, I am the Lord your God. After the doing of the land of Egypt, where ye dwell, shall ye not do.
That's it. I'm God. You're going to do what I say. That's it. That's the whole thing. You understand? Señora, ¿quiere una pregunta? ¿Está escuchando? Ok. ¿Te puedo hacer una pregunta? ¿Tú amas a Dios?
Yo amo a Dios.
¿Tú amas a Cristo?
Yo soy católica, yo amo a Dios.
Ok, yo era católico aún.
¿Habla español?
Yo creo que es inglés, ¿verdad?
Ok.
Yo
era católico.
¿Era?
Era. ¿Por qué era? ¿Por qué yo era? ¿Por qué yo no soy católico? En la iglesia católica hay ciertas cosas, hay ciertas preguntas que usted ha tenido en la católica que nunca te ha dado la respuesta, ¿right? ¿Sí o no? ¿Por qué? Yo te voy a hacer una pregunta, señora. ¿Por qué en la católica le dan honra a estatua? ¿Escuchaste la pregunta? ¿Por qué en la católica tienen estatua y le dan honra? Honra, honra, honor, honra. ¿Por qué en la católica le dan honra a una estatua? Esta es la ley. ¿Usted tiene un santo preferido? ¿Usted tiene un santo preferido?
Yo amo a Dios.
Tú amas a Dios, ¿sabes? Pero tú dices que tú eres católica, ¿right? Oh, era católica, ok. So, ¿qué es lo que usted estudia? ¿Qué es lo que usted estudia?
Testigo de Jehová.
¿Ah? Oh, testigo de Jehová. Really? Me sorprende porque los testigos de Jehová no se ponen sus pantalones. Hay cosas que están en la Biblia que ustedes creen que saben, pero no saben. Nosotros estamos aquí para enseñarle a ustedes que nosotros, los morenos, los latinos, los indios nativos, son los israelitas que Dios eligió para este mundo.
El libro de Deuteronomio, capítulo 22, versículo 5. No vestirá la mujer traje de hombre, ni el hombre vestirá ropa de mujer.
Si tú ves a un hombre con una falda, ¿qué usted cree? Maricón, right? Ok. Si usted ve a un hombre con taco, con brasier, con panty, homosexual, right? Ahora, ¿qué tú dices si tú ves a una mujer en pantalones? Oh, ahora dice marimacha. So una mujer es marimacha si se pone pantalones. Ahora, si una mujer se pone pantalones cortos, ¿ella es marimacha también? So, ¿qué es lo que usted tiene puesto? Pero tú no eras marimacha. So, ¿cuál es el problema? ¿Tú ves la diferencia? ¿Tú entiendes? Estamos tratando de llegar a usted con un entendimiento. ¿Ok? Porque estas son cosas que la católica, los testigos de Jehová, los adventistas, la gente de todas estas diferentes religiones no nos enseñan acerca de la Biblia. Nosotros no tenemos religión. Cuando Moisés fue al monte de Sinaí, ¿qué es lo que Dios le dio a Moisés para dar a la gente? ¿Fue religión? ¿Qué es lo que fue? Fueron mandamientos, no religión. So, la religión no existe. Mi religión, si tú quieres ver, es mantener los mandamientos. That's it. Ecclesiastes chapter 12. Vamos a ver cuál es la religión de nosotros. ¿Ok? Porque esa es la pregunta que todo el mundo cree. Mucha gente cree que nosotros somos musulmanes. Nosotros no somos los musulmanes. Esto es lo que nosotros somos.
Eclesiastes capítulo 12, versículo 13. El fin de todo discurso es este.
So, el fin de todo el discurso, de la pregunta de cuál es la religión de nosotros, es esta.
Temer a Dios y guardar sus mandamientos. El fin de todo discurso.
So, el fin, la respuesta de tu pregunta en cuál es nuestra religión es esta.
Oír es este. Temer a Dios.
Tú tienes que tenerle temor a Dios.
Y guardar sus mandamientos.
Y guardar sus mandamientos. Pero tú sabes qué, señora. Ustedes ahora mismo están rompiendo los mandamientos. ¿Por qué? Porque uno, toditas tienen pantalones. Y dos, están comprando coquitos en el día de reposo. Vamos con los pantalones otra vez. Ven, señora, no te oigo.
Okay. El libro de Deuteronomio, capítulo 22, versículo 5.
Eso es para todas ustedes mujeres. Para mujeres que dicen que creen que ellos aman a Dios. Esta es la escritura para usted.
No vestirá la mujer traje de hombre.
Cada mujer que camina por aquí con pantalones está actuando como un hombre. Cada mujer que camina por acá con pantalones apretados, con spandex, enseñando las nalgas y enseñándolo de frente, que es lo que la Biblia dice.
No vestirá la mujer traje de hombre.
Eso es una falta de respeto. Eso es la razón por qué la mayoría de las mujeres no tienen esposo. Eso es porque la mayoría de las mujeres no tienen esposo dirigiendo la casa. ¿Por qué? Porque tú le faltas respeto a ti mismo poniéndote pantalones apretados. Un hombre no te va a dar respeto cuando tú estás enseñando todo lo justo. Todo lo que tú tienes, los senos para afuera, nalga para afuera, cadera para afuera, todo para afuera. Y después tú quieres que un hombre te dé respeto. ¿Cómo? ¿Cómo es posible que tú quieres que un hombre te dé respeto si tú estás enseñando todo lo bueno que tú tienes físicamente? La mujer con buen cuerpo, hasta la mujer con mal cuerpo también, tiene todas las carnes para afuera. What is this?
Lea eso otra vez. No vestirá la mujer traje de hombre.
No te pongan los pantalones ustedes mujeres. Sí, ya, shut up. Pero eso es lo que ustedes me dicen a nosotros. Shut up. Pero estamos diciendo lo que dice la Biblia. Esto es lo que Dios dice. Sigue leyendo.
Ni el hombre vestirá ropa de mujer.
Ahora, es un problema si tú ves a un hombre con una falda. ¿Cuál es la hipocresía de eso? Si tú ves con un hombre con una falda, automáticamente es un homosexual. Pero si tú ves a una mujer con pantalones, eso está bien. That doesn't make sense. ¿Cuál es la hipocresía ahí? Eso trae.
No vestirá la mujer traje de hombre, ni el hombre vestirá ropa de mujer, porque abominación es a Jehová tu Dios, cualquiera que hace eso.
Salmo 81:12. Ok, ustedes creen que saben todo, pero no saben nada. Tienen que aprender otra vez de lo que la Biblia dice. ¿Sí o no, señores, señora? ¿Ah? Ustedes están perdidos en tu iglesia, con tus pastores, en el cristianismo, en el espiritismo, en la brujería, en la santería. Ustedes están perdidos. Read.
El libro de Salmo, capítulo 81, versículo 12. Los dejé, por tanto, en la dureza de su corazón.
Ustedes tienen el corazón o la mente dura. De ahí es que viene la palabra cabeza dura. ¿Por qué? Porque tú quieres hacer lo que te da la gana. ¿Okay?
Las mujeres que te dicen así provoca a nosotros.
Bueno, eso es la cosa. Pero nosotros tenemos que hacer lo que Dios dice.
Los dejé, por tanto, en la dureza de su corazón.
¿Por qué tú crees que hay tantos problemas y tantas cosas en nuestra comunidad?
Porque la misma mujer que dice así, provoca.
Porque nosotros no hacemos la voluntad de Dios. ¿No?
Caminaron en sus propios consejos.
Uno cree que está haciendo, una persona cree que está haciendo las cosas bien, porque creen que ellos están bien. Y no es así. ¿Tú entiendes? Cuando tú te vestiste esta mañana, tú creíste que tú estabas bien, pero desafortunadamente no está bien. ¿Tú entiendes? Las mujeres no se dan cuenta. Yo soy adulto como usted. Yo hablo franco, yo hablo duro. ¿Ok? Pero las mujeres saben a conciencia que cuando se ponen los pantalones, la vagina se ve.
Pero yo no me pongo así.
Se ve, claramente se ve. ¿Tú entiendes? Estas son cosas que no quieren escuchar. Eso es lo que es. Cuando una mujer se pone spandex, se ve la vagina. ¿Ok? Es evidente. Read on.
Oh, si me hubiera oído mi pueblo.
Si tú hubieras escuchado a Dios.
Si en mis caminos hubieras andado, Israel.
Si tú hubieras caminado en los caminos de Dios.
En un momento. Habría yo derribado a sus enemigos.
Nosotros hubieran optado ya en el reino. Si tú hubieras por un momento hubieras hecho lo que Dios dice, todos nosotros pudiéramos estar en el reino hoy día. Disculpa, ayer, la semana pasada, el año pasado, antes de tu nacer, nosotros hubiéramos estado en el reino ya. Pero no, porque nosotros queremos hacer lo que nos da la gana. Nosotros estamos en las condiciones que nosotros estamos hoy. Déjalo otra vez.
En un momento habría yo derribado a sus enemigos.
Dios hubiera deshecho a todos los enemigos.
Y vuelto mi mano contra sus adversarios. Los que te aborrecen, oh, a Jehová, se levantarán sometidos.
Ok. So, señora, ¿de dónde tú eres en esta?
Yo soy de Perú.
¿Ah?
Peruana.
Peruana. Perú. Usted está Neftalí, right? Perú. Pero está cerca de Chile, Perú. So, tú vienes de la tribu de Neftalí. Tú eres la primera persona que yo he conocido que viene de la tribu de Neftalí.
El libro de Génesis, capítulo 49, versículo 1. Y llamó Jacob a sus hijos y dijo: juntaos y os declararé lo que os acontecerá en los días venideros.
Nosotros estamos en los días venideros. Y estos son los últimos días. Los últimos días empezaron desde el momento que Cristo nació. ¿Ok? Pero nosotros, ahora te está explicando Jacob, o sea, Israel, el padre de los 12 tribus de Israel. Nos está explicando en qué es lo que va a pasar en estos últimos días.
El libro de Génesis, capítulo 41, versículo 20. El pan de Aser será sustancioso.
Sustancioso, o sea, precioso, delicioso. Los colombianos, peruanos, la gente de Brasil, Ecuador, toda esa región. Ustedes hacen la comida bien buena, ¿ok? El pan con delicadeza, ¿ok? Ese es para hacerte saber de dónde usted viene.
El pan de Aser será sustancioso y él dará deleite al rey.
Deleite del rey, o sea, bien, bien fino, ¿ok? La comida de ustedes bien fino.
Vamos a ver.
Ella es mi mamá.
Hola, señora. Ahora vamos a verlo.
Tiene 105 años.
¿Cuánto?
105.
Bueno, ahora ella todavía tiene una oportunidad para arrepentirse y hacer la voluntad de Dios. 105 años.
El libro de Deuteronomio, capítulo 32, versículo 24. Consumidos serán de hambre y devorados de fiebre ardiente y de pestes amargas. Dientes de fieras enviará también sobre con ellos, con veneno y serpientes de tierra. El libro de Deuteronomio, capítulo 33, versículo 24.
Estas son las bendiciones que le van a caer a Asher.
A Asher dijo: bendito sobre los hijos sea Asher.
Porque sobre los hijos que sean Asher. Porque ustedes tienen muchos hijos.
Sea el amado de sus hermanos.
Y todos los latinos le tienen cariño a la gente de Colombia, a la gente de Ecuador, a la gente de Perú, de Brasil. Todos nosotros buscamos a ustedes. ¿Okay?
Bendito los hijos de Asher, sea el amado de sus hermanos y moje en aceite sus pies.
Moje en aceite, o sea, ustedes tienen riqueza en esos países. El mundo entero va a ustedes buscando aceite, petróleo. ¿Okay? Hugo Chávez. Okay. Él tenía el control sobre eso para ayudar a nosotros aquí, no a América, sino a nosotros, porque nosotros estábamos aquí. Pero la gente lo enseñaron como si fuera un dictador. Aquí, este país. ¿Por qué? Porque él no quería hacer lo que la voluntad de lo que América quería. ¿Tú entiendes? Aquí, en este país, lo pintaron como un desgraciado, pero no era. Él amaba a su gente. Pero no amaba a la gente que nos dirige a nosotros aquí.
Versículo 25. Hierro y bronce, tus cerrojos.
Otra vez, esos son son cosas naturales de la tierra que ustedes tienen, riqueza de la tierra.
Y como tus días serán tus fuerzas.
Y como tus días, porque ella tiene 105 años, como tus días
serán tus fuerzas.
Serán tus fuerzas. Ella tiene una fuerza, 105 años. Eso no se ve todos los días. Como sus días serán sus fuerzas. Eso porque nosotros allá en Asher duran mucho. Y es evidente porque ella aquí tiene 105 años.
Ella es mi mamá y ella es
tu mamá. Ella es tu mamá, right. Pero sea como sea, las dos tienen que arrepentirse en tu casa. ¿Okay? Sea como sea, ustedes, ella, usted tiene que arrepentirse.
El libro de Mateo, capítulo 3, versículo 1. En aquellos días vino Juan el Bautista, predicando en el desierto de Judá y diciendo: arrepentíos, porque el reino de los cielos se ha acercado.
So, tienen una oportunidad para arrepentirse. ¿Okay? No te pongas pantalones, tú eres una mujer. Los testigos de Jehová no te van a enseñar eso. ¿Okay? Ellos no te van a enseñar eso.
El libro de Salmos, capítulo 19, versículo 7.
¿Usted escuchó eso, señora? ¿Escuchaste eso? ¿Dice bien?
El libro de Salmos, capítulo 19, versículo 7. La ley de Jehová es perfecta.
La ley de Jehová es perfecta.
Que convierte el alma.
Y eso es lo que hace a uno cambiar. ¿Okay? Cuando uno se separa de hacer la ley de tu mente y tú haces la ley de Dios, que es perfecta, uno cambia. ¿Okay? Nosotros somos hombres, right? ¿Sí? Tú y yo somos hombres. Nosotros aquí somos hombres. Hay una mujer fina que pasa aquí con cadera, whatever. Automáticamente, wow, mami. That's not good. Pues, no sé si usted tiene una esposa, pero yo sí. Muchos de nosotros tenemos esposas también. Pero nosotros tenemos que seguir la ley de Dios. Y la ley nos dice que nosotros no estamos supuestos a hacer eso. Esa ley es perfecta. Léelo otra vez.
El libro de Salmos, capítulo 19, versículo 7. La ley de Jehová es perfecta.
La ley de Dios es perfecta, pero la ley de Dios no se está enseñando en tu iglesia. ¿Entendiste? La ley de Dios no se está enseñando en la iglesia. ¿Okay? Señora, Dios quiere, nosotros vamos a estar aquí el próximo sábado. ¿Eh? ¿Ok? Señora, mucho gusto. ¿Ok? ¿Okay? La ley de Dios es perfecta. ¿Lee?
La ley de Jehová es perfecta, que convierte el alma.
Si tú amas a Dios, si tú amas a Cristo, no te va a molestar lo que la ley dice. ¿Qué es?
El testimonio de Jehová es fiel.
El testimonio de Jehová es fiel. ¿Qué es?
Que hace sabio al sencillo.
Que hace tu sabiduría sencillo. Lo que tú tienes en tu mente es sencillo acerca de lo que Dios dice, que es mucho sabiduría. ¿Ok? Estamos aquí, nosotros amamos a nuestra gente, los morenos, latinos, los indios nativos. Nosotros estamos aquí para ustedes. Pero muchos de nuestros hermanos creen que nosotros les tenemos odio. Hay cierta gente que venden coquitos que creen que nosotros les tenemos odio. No es así. Que venden joyería y creen que nosotros les tenemos odio. No es así. Pero lee lo que la Biblia dice.
El libro de Salmos, capítulo 81, versículo 12. Los dejé, por tanto, a la dureza de su corazón.
Esa es la razón por qué mucha de nuestra gente tiene problemas hoy día. ¿Por qué tú crees que tú no tienes una esposa? ¿Por qué tú crees que usted no tiene un esposo? Es por eso, porque tú estás duro. Tú no quieres hacer lo que Dios dice. Sigue.
Caminaron en sus propios consejos.
Tú caminaste por lo que tú creías que estaba bien. Tú no caminaste acerca de lo que Dios dice. Eso es porque nosotros tenemos problemas hoy día. Read.
Oh, si me hubiesen oído mi pueblo,
si tú hubieras escuchado lo que Dios dice,
si en mis caminos hubiera andado Israel,
si tú hubieras andado en los caminos de lo que Dios te dice,
en un momento habría yo derribado a sus enemigos.
En un momento, cualquier persona que te echaba malicia acerca de ti hubiera estado destruido.
Y vuelto mi mano contra sus adversarios.
Y los que tienen odio acerca de ti también.
Los que aborrecen a Jehová se le habrían sometido. Y el tiempo de ellos será para siempre.
Pero tú sabes lo que nosotros hacemos. ¿Qué es lo que nosotros hacemos, los puertorriqueños específicamente? ¿Qué es lo que nosotros hacemos? Nosotros vamos en el sábado a un centro, vamos a un babalao, vamos a una santera, vamos en espiritista, right? Nos sentamos en una mesa blanca, nosotros jugamos tambores, and all that garbage. Le damos oraciones a Changó, a Yemayá, o Batalá. ¿Ah? ¿Para qué? Esa gente tiene un negocio. Tú me vas a decir a mí que el sábado pasado tú fuiste a una limpieza, pagaste 200, 300, 400 dólares por una vela, un coco, un collar, para después ir hoy sábado para que te digan lo mismo que la misma gente. Te están tirando otra vez. Abre los ojos, es un negocio. Yo te puedo decir esto porque yo a un tiempo era un espiritista. Pero ustedes están perdidos. Tú estás cogiendo el consejo que lo que tú crees que está bien y no está bien. Lee eso otra vez.
Oh, si me hubiera oído mi pueblo y en mis caminos hubiera andado Israel, en un momento habría derribado yo a sus enemigos.
Si tú haces lo que Dios dice, hay bendiciones para ti. Pero no hay bendiciones con Changó. No hay bendiciones con siete potencias. Esa porquería. Siete potencias, porquería. Siete potencias, siete porquería. That's what it is. El agua, porquería. Todos esos santos son porquería. Go to Salmo 73 y 24. Ustedes no saben lo que están haciendo. La Santa Muerte, porquería. Guadalupe, porquería. Y lo digo 10,000 veces, porquería. Go ahead.
Me has guiado según tu consejo.
Nosotros estamos supuestos a coger los consejos de Dios, no los consejos del mundo. El mundo te dice que te hinque enfrente de una estatua y fumar un tabaco y echarle ron. Pero eso no son cosas que nosotros estamos supuestos a hacer. Changó, El Egua, Santa Bárbara, porquería, todo. Read on.
El libro de Salmos, capítulo 73, versículo 24. Me has guiado según tu consejo.
Nosotros estamos supuestos a dejar que Dios nos guíe por su consejo, o sea, por medio de la Biblia.
Y después me recibirás en gloria.
Y después nosotros vamos a estar en gloria con Dios. Pero nosotros no podemos estar en gloria si nosotros estamos yendo a un centro en oscuridad, buscando Congo. What the hell is this? Buscando Congo y apestando a agua florida. Eso no son cosas que nosotros estamos supuestos a hacer. Sí, señora, tú sabes lo que yo hago. Muchos de ustedes fueron a ¿cómo es? A Boyé. ¿Sí o no? ¿Quién aquí conoce a Boyé que vivía en la 120? ¿Quién aquí conoce a Boyé? ¿Ok? Ella sí era una buena mujer. Pero acerca de la Biblia no era una buena mujer. Y yo lo puedo decir porque ella era familia mía. Pero ella no estaba haciendo la voluntad de Dios. Aunque ustedes creen que estaba haciendo la voluntad de Dios. Aunque ustedes creen que tú estabas haciendo la voluntad de Dios. No lo están haciendo. Lee.
¿A quién tengo yo en los cielos sino a ti? y la fuerza de ti nada deseo en la tierra.
Ok, nosotros no estamos supuestos a desear las cosas de esta tierra. Nosotros no estamos supuestos a buscar a una estatua para que nos den ayuda. Yes. Ok, vea un momento, señor.
No, pero me tengo que ir.
Oh, tú te tienes que ir. Ok. All right. Te va a ir a la destrucción si tú no haces lo que Dios dice. ¿Tú entiendes, señor? Hay cosas que están en esta Biblia que la iglesia no nos están enseñando y estamos perdidos. ¿Tú entiendes? ¿Cómo usted se llama? No tiene nada. ¿Cómo usted se llama?
Luis.
Yo me llamo Abiel. Estos son mis hermanos. Que okay, nosotros estamos aquí para enseñarlo a nuestra gente que son la gente elegida de Dios. ¿Tú no lo sabías? ¿Tú lo sabías? Usted sabe, ¿right? Come here.
Go ahead, I go loud.
Okay, you believe in God. All right, let's see. Yeah, we're back.
El libro de Habacuc, capítulo 2, versículo 18.
Watch this.
¿De qué sirve la escultura que esculpió el que la hizo?
¿De qué sirve una estatua de Cristo? ¿De qué sirve un collar o un rosario? ¿De qué sirve?
¿De qué sirve la escultura que esculpió el que la hizo?
El que la hizo, una persona que es del mundo. ¿Qué es lo que sirve una estatua que viene del mismo mundo?
La estatua de fundición que enseña mentira.
Eso enseña mentira porque es una faz de una persona que no existió.
¿Para qué haciendo imágenes mudas confíen en el hacedor de sus obras?
Como una foto o como una imagen. Tú tienes una imagen de un Cristo así, crucificado, o una dichosa santa, la Santa Muerte, o la Virgen María, están ahí mirándote. Y uno, cuando te cae polvo en tus ojos, ¿qué es lo que uno hace? Señor, ¿qué es lo que, si polvo te cae en el ojo, ¿qué es lo que tú haces? Te limpia el ojo, ¿right? Porque molesta, te pica. Oh, man. Pero una estatua puede estar ahí por años. Y hay años de polvo cayendo en los ojos y no le pica porque no le mire.
Ay, de aquel que dice al malo, despiértate.
So hay o destrucción para usted si usted dice, párate al palo o a la piedra.
Despiértate a la piedra muda. Levántate, podrá él enseñar.
Porque nada de esta estatua nos van a ayudar. ¿Por qué en la iglesia hay estatua de la Guadalupe? La Guadalupe es el diablo. Yes, yes, lo vi. La Virgen María, diablo. Si estoy mal, ven y habla con nosotros. Dime si estoy mal o no. Enséñame que estoy mal. No me digas que estoy mal. Pero enséñame por medio de la Biblia que lo que yo te dice no está mal. Porque la misma Biblia te dice que todas esas estatuas son del diablo. Yes. Sigue.
He aquí, está cubierto de oro y de plata.
So, están vestidos bien. Tiene su obra, su obra de oro, de plata, todas estas cosas, right? Go ahead.
Y no hay espíritu dentro de él.
Y no vive, no tiene aliento, no huele, no mira, no te habla, no te dice, ok, hermano, todo va a estar bien. No te hace esas cosas, no anda contigo. Go ahead.
Mas Jehová está en su santo templo. Cállese delante de él toda la tierra.
Toda la tierra va a caer adelante de él si no hace lo que Dios dice. Hey, can I ask you a question?
All day, all night. How can I help you, brother?
What are you into?
What do you mean, what am I into? Meaning what? Specify much better.
Spiritual.
What do you mean?
Spiritual.
Myself. Spiritual. I'm into oneself. That's what I'm into.
You're into one
yeah, I'm into self. I built the earth. Why? What happened?
You built the earth?
Yeah.
Let me ask you a question.
the shells and everything, the beads that you have on, does that come from the earth also?
Yes, it does.
Really?
Yeah.
I heard from what I hear.
What you hear from?
What I hear, plastic is man-made. I don't think it comes from the earth.
What else is man-made?
You tell me.
You tell me. You said, well, come from what else?
You're into oneself,
so I
want to know.
How do you live? What do you eat? This. What do you eat? What don't know how to
do
it, you tell me.
I'll show you.
I know mine. Don't have him read it. You do it.
I gotta go with what
no, you don't. I want you to go with what he says. Because I got it right here. I don't need nobody else to translate for me. You do it. That's what I want you to do.
Chapter
I know that
already.
I read that book 25 years ago.
Let's appeal the conclusion of the whole matter.
So I'm going to answer your question.
Yeah, no, I want you. Don't let him read.
I let the Bible speak.
No, you speak.
Let's hear the conclusion of the whole matter.
So let's hear the conclusion of the whole matter.
Fear God.
I already know all that.
I keep his commandments.
I did all that.
I fear God and I keep his commandments.
Okay. Go ahead. So you tell
me. This is the whole duty of man.
And that's the whole duty of man. Bro.
Is it really?
That's what oneself.
What's oneself? I don't want to hear what he's saying.
We're supposed to be doing this.
I did that already. I read that already. Okay. But what do you eat? I want to know what you eat at home. How do you live at home? Tell me. How do you live at home? What do you eat at home?
We eat food,
like
we
drink water.
We don't eat pork. We don't eat pork.
I haven't had meat in 35 years.
We keep the commandments.
I don't do dairy. I don't
That's
do
your
soda.
Choice.
I don't do juice.
However,
I don't do pasta.
However,
I don't do none of that.
However, do you keep the commandments?
Every day. I done did that already. I live it. I walk it. I live it every day.
Yeah.
I grew up right here 45 years.
Okay, let's
see. No, you read it. Stop telling him to read it, man.
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 27.
Read.
Jesus not broke the corner of your path.
Hold on. Did you hear that?
I done read that. You keep telling me that I hear something, that I read it already. You keep telling me that I hear something. I live that. You read it. You read it. Read St. Luke. Read Deuteronomy. Read Ezekiel.
You gotta read that.
I already read that book. 30
listen,
years ago. You say it. Don't worry about him saying it. Because that book is gone. Are you going to be able to manifest and tell your own truth for square?
To the house
book is
of
not
God.
There?
Brother, you need to keep your foot when thou comest to the house of the Lord.
When
not?
Are you not?
I'm
gonna
more
manifest
ready
your truth for square
to hear
when that book ain't there.
Than do giving the sacrifice of food.
Do you understand you're giving the sacrifice of food?
Do you understand?
Do you understand you're giving the sacrifice of food? Read it again. The brother didn't hear.
I listen. I don't need to hear. I listen. No, I'm building.
You're not listening. You're not building anything.
I listen.
You're building an argument.
I'm not
You're not listening.
I already know that.
You're telling me
something
I already know.
Why would I hear that again? When thou goes to the heart of God.
I am true and living. Yes, I am.
I'm ready to hear.
I'm true and living. Always have been. Always will.
You need to be more ready to hear than to give the
sacrifice. No, when you hear, it goes through one ear and come out the other. When you listen, it restores your memory bank. I don't hear when you listen. It restores your memory bank. You don't hear. You listen. That's how you comprehend.
You're not considering that you do evil, bro. You're not listening. You are stuck in your own way.
Yo,
go back to that scripture.
Man. Your level of persuasion is not going to work.
I'm not trying. Listen.
It's not going to work.
Listen,
you got to live it out every day.
Whatever you
want to can't keep manifesting it. You got to live it. You got to show people.
Listen,
stop
we all
doing
living.
This.
We all living.
Living
right.
it. Living.
Listen, that's
living.
What you
got. You got a garden? Are you growing your own?
You got to stop doing this.
I don't have to because I'm doing good.
Okay?
I'm doing good.
You about yourself.
No, I'm not.
I'm about my people.
I'm not about myself.
I'm not here for
doing good.
Just for myself.
You feel me?
I'm not here
you
for oneself.
I'm here for everybody.
Read that.
I got a diabetic right now who lost 47 pounds from being with me. Don't take no more medication. Fuck out of here, man. I'm true and living, bitch. I don't know about that.
Let's see. 73:24. You people
thou shalt give me with thy counsel and afterward present me to glory.
Okay? You think that you know everything, but you want to continue in your own counsel. You think that we're here just for fun and games. We're not here for fun and games. We are here to let you know that you are in the midst of sin and you are going to die a horrible death. That's it. If you don't keep God's commandments, you have a chance to repent and come out of the wickedness that you're in right now. But no, you're too busy running your mouth. And you think that you know more than any of us. You don't know a damn thing. Read that again.
Psalms 73, verse 24. Thou shalt get me with thy counsel, and afterward receive me to glory.
If you keep God's commandments, you will be received in glory. Go ahead.
Whom I have in heaven, but thee and there is now upon earth that I desire before thee. My flesh and my heart fell, but God is my strength
and my heart in my bosom forever.
God is your strength, not the chains and shackles that are around your neck. You understand? The necklaces that all our people wear that are stuck in Santeria and all this witchcraft. It is a chain and shackle of this world. You have no idea what you're doing. But no, you want to talk about oneself. You want to talk about so many other things, and you don't want to listen. Go back to keeping your foot. You have no idea. You understand. You must understand. We are learned men in this Bible. We are not here to play no games. And we understand that our people are stuck in ignorance. Read on.
Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 1. Keep thy food when goes to the house of God.
You don't understand that this is the house of God right now. This is the house of God. Read on.
I'm a bit more ready to hear that giving the sacrifice of food.
You must be more ready to listen because you came and you're listening and that's good. You understand? And we give you we give all our people, blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, those are the children of Israel. We give them the opportunity to ask questions. But if you're making statements and you want to run your mouth thinking that you know more, we're not going to tolerate that. We're not going to entertain it. We must keep the commandments and we must teach what God says. Read it again.
Keep thy food when thou goes to the house of God.
When you come to us, you gotta keep whatever philosophy or whatever, you gotta keep that over there. Read on.
I'm a bit more ready to hear.
You must be more ready to listen.
Than do giving the sacrifice of food.
Than giving the sacrifice of food. You know what a fool is, right? What is a fool? Brother, do you know what a fool is? Does anyone know what a fool is? A fool is someone that does something that they don't know, what they have no understanding. Like running your mouth. You might say something that could get you into big trouble. You understand? Read on.
For they consider not that they do evil.
Because you're not considering that you're doing evil. You understand? It's like walking the street when there's a stop sign while cars are going.
Alrighty.
That's an act of a fool. You're not considering that you might get hit by a car. But we're here to let you know you're gonna get hit by a car if you cross the street while cars are going. That is the sacrifice of a fool, you understand? Read on.
Be not rash with thy mouth.
Don't be rash with your mouth. Don't run your mouth, man.
And let not thy heart be hasty.
Don't be, man.
To utter anything before God.
Don't be hasty to utter anything before God. Know what you're about to say. We ask you a question, just give us a straight answer. And then learn. Because we are here to teach. We're not here to learn nothing from anyone. We are here to teach. We have spent years learning this Bible to come here and teach you that you're doing wrong so that you can get it right. That's it. We're not here to play no games. Keep your foot when thou goest to the house of the Lord and be more ready to hear than to give the sacrifice of fools. That's what the Bible says. You have a question? What's your nationality according to the Bible, according to the sign?
No, I'm good. Don't do it.
I can't hear you. Say it again.
Don't do it.
Huh? Say it again. We're here to teach our people, bro. What's your nationality? What's your nationality, bro? You with the yellow shirt. You don't have a nationality? You filled out a job application before, right? Have you filled out a job application before? You've never filled out a job application. All right, let me go to Isaiah chapter 3. That's crazy. Y'all straight liars out here. How is it possible that a grown man has never filled out a job application? That's lying. All right. Yes.
They ought nowhere his omnia.
So a dumb animal like an ox knows his owner. A dumb ox knows exactly where he needs to go. You know?
And the earth his master grip.
And a jackass knows where he lives. Okay?
But Israel.
But my people, blacks, Latinos, Native Americans,
do not know.
So God is saying that his own people are dumber than an ox and are dumber than asses. Read it again.
The earth knoweth his owners.
Uh-huh.
The earth his master grip. But Israel does not know. My people does not consider it.
You don't consider that you're doing wrong. You don't want to consider. You don't even want to think that you're doing wrong. You understand? Go to Psalm chapter 14 and 1. Psalm chapter 14 and 1 will bring you even further. You understand? These are things, listen, we're here to bring you to another level. Because our people are below the basement. Our people, blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, you're underneath the basement. But you're royalty. You're just walking in a whole bunch of dirt. In your tight pants. In your skirts. You so-called men with skirts acting all effeminate. Not filling out job applications. What the hell is this? Read that.
Psalm 14 verse 1. The fool has said in his heart, there is no God.
So there's fools out here that say that there is no God. Like this brother that came up earlier saying that he's about oneself. That is a fool that says that there is no God. Because when you say that you're oneself, you're saying that you created yourself. And you created the universe before yourself. That's what you're saying. You're saying you're above the Most High. That is evil as hell. You know?
They are corrupt. They have done abominable work. There is not that doeth good.
You're not doing good. You're not considering. No, today's the Sabbath, bro. But listen, hold on before you leave. You want to pay us? Okay, here's how you're gonna donate today, right now. You're gonna donate by sticking around. Donate your time. You don't got time? Do you know that you will get destroyed if you don't keep God's commandments? You already know? Leviticus chapter 19.
Watch this.
Keep your money. Keep your money. Keep your money for now. Tomorrow you can donate. But take a flyer and listen to the scripture. Listen, here's how you're going to donate time. Read that.
Leviticus 19, verse 26.
We'll accept your donation of time. Okay? Read that.
Ye shall not wrong the corner of your hair.
So the law says you're not supposed to shave your head bald. Read on.
Neither.
Keep your money.
Neither shalt thou mark the corner of your beard.
You should not shave your beard off, bro. That is the law. Read. Right. Well, grow it now. Now you know the law. You understand? We're here to edify you, to bring you up, to come, to help you come out of the wickedness that you're in. You understand? You drinking? Drinking, right? Okay. Let's see what the scripture says about that. Okay. Well, no. Listen, we're not going to take your money. If you want to donate, donate tomorrow. Go online, send a donation there. But right now, donate your time. Donate, listen. Donate your ears. Listen to what this Bible has to say. You got it? Watch this. Because these are things that the Bible, these are things that the churches don't teach. You have to understand, you have to come out of the wickedness that you're in. You understand? You got it? Drinking. Listen to this.
Okay, you got it?
First Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9. acknowledging now that the unrighteousness shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
So the unrighteousness, the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Let's find out what some things that are unrighteous that will cause you to not receive the kingdom of God. Okay?
Be not deceived, neither fornicators.
So fornicators, like brothers who like a lot of women, brothers who want to go, who use women as buffet tables. You want to have one woman Monday, you got another woman Tuesday. Her name is Wednesday, and you got a chick named Thursday. You know?
Not idolater.
So you're not supposed to have an idolater. Like the foolish man I was working here with a hat full of, with a hat full of a niñito antocha on his head. Go ahead.
Not adulterous.
Now adulterous. Because a lot of men want to sleep around. Again, you want to deal with married women. And you women want to deal with married men. You're not going to get the kingdom of God. Go ahead.
Not effeminate.
Now, nor effeminate, nor men that have female tendencies. You understand? Men that have a switch. Hey, how you doing? Acting all funny like that. You can't be having that. You're not gonna get the kingdom of heaven. Go ahead.
Not abusive himself with mankind.
Now that same effeminate man will abuse himself with another man. Or a woman that will abuse herself with another woman. So that's going into homosexuality. God hates that thing. Men with men, women with women, it's all evil. God does not like that. You will not enter into the kingdom of heaven. You don't?
Not thief.
Y'all want to take things. A lot of y'all got sticky fingers. You're not going to get into the kingdom of heaven. You ain't going to pick the lock to the gates. It ain't happening. Go ahead.
Not covetous.
Those people who hate other people that have things that they don't want. Damn, that's a nice watch. I hate that nigga. I want his watch, and I can't have it. That's covetous. You're not going to get into the kingdom, man.
Not drunkards.
Nor drunkards, like the brother that was here. He wanted to donate a dollar. It's the Sabbath. You understand? Donate tomorrow. But he was obviously drunk. You cannot drink. You can drink, but if you're drunk or you lose your mind, you're out of order. You understand? You're not going to get the kingdom. You're not.
Not revilers.
A person that's always looking for trouble. Why are you looking at my shoes, man? I'll punch you in your face. That's crazy. Go ahead.
Not extortionists.
Oh, I got some dirt on you. Listen, if you want to keep your job, you know what you need to do, right? That's extortion. I'm not going to get the kingdom if I'm into that. Go ahead.
Shall inherit the kingdom of God.
So all those things, the Bible goes into specifics as to how you're not going to get into the kingdom. You know?
And such were some of you.
So now, as such were some of us. Because listen, if you happen to be in any of those wicked sins, trust and believe that you have a chance to repent. Because some of us were some of those examples. Some of us were wrapped up in some of those sins. But we have repented. We've transcended from those wicked things. And we're here to let you know that you, brother, you have a chance. Sister, you have a chance to come out of those sins. Just like we got the chance. We repented. The Most High said that we could get out of it. We're here to tell you that you can get out of it just like we did. You have a chance to repent. That's what we're here to do. That's what we're here to do. You understand? We may come here rough and blasting and stuff like that, but listen, this is all love. You understand? If you're about to get hit by a bus, let me ask you, bro. If you're about to get hit by a bus, are you gonna give me? You gonna show, bro?
We walked away, bro.
Are you gonna really take me serious if I'm talking like that?
Yeah.
Are you gonna take me serious? But you gotta take me serious. Yo, bro, watch out!
If you say watch out, I'm gonna walk away.
Not in a soft voice. It don't make sense.
Read that.
2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 5. Casting down imagination.
That's what we're here to do. We're here to cast down the gods of your imagination. Because all of you serve another god. You got the god of spandex. You got the god of midnight dragon. You got the god of Planet Fitness. You got the god of showing your pants below your butt. You got the god of your own imagination. You're not serving the god of the Bible. You're not serving the god of Israel. But we're here to cast down the imagination, your imagination of what you think is correct. Read it again.
Casting down imagination.
We're here to cast down your imagination. Go ahead.
And every high thing accepting itself against the knowledge of God.
And we are here to cast down anything that exalts itself above the knowledge of God. You understand? Like your birthday. A lot of people wanted to celebrate their birthday today. You understand? A lot of y'all want to go to City Island. Or y'all want to go to your favorite restaurant and buy on the Sabbath. You're exalting yourself above the knowledge of God. A lot of y'all want to be homosexual. You're exalting yourself above the knowledge of God. When God says that homosexuality is out of order. When God says that a woman cannot wear pants, and you women wear pants anyway, you're exalting yourself above the knowledge of God. When you men shave off your beards, when you men have your pants below your butt, you are exalting yourself above the knowledge of God. Read on.
I'm bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
You know how we do that? We do that by reading the scriptures to you. We are going to bring into captivity anything that you think is correct. A woman says, I can wear pants. No, click, click. Into captivity. The Bible says you're supposed to wear a skirt. I'm gonna shave my beard. No, click, click. We're gonna bring you into captivity. The Bible says you're supposed to wear your beard. Read that part again.
I'm bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
All the thoughts that are in your mind must be into the captivity of what God says. You're supposed to be prisoners of Christ, not prisoners of this world. Hold that and go to Colossians chapter 2 and verse 8. Let me explain that part. You're supposed to bring yourself into being what Christ says, you're not supposed to serve what this world teaches.
I have my
watch this.
Colossians chapter 2, verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and bend the sea.
You so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, you are spoiled through vain deceits. And what else?
Philosophy.
Through philosophies and vain deceit. The philosophy that a woman can wear pants. You're destroyed. The philosophy that you can smoke weed. You are destroyed. You're under the philosophy of vain deceits. It's a lie. Crack is a hell of a, cocaine is a hell of a drug. It is, and it's going to bring you death. Your pants are gonna bring you death. Women, you men that act effeminate, you're gonna bring death upon yourself too. Read it again.
Colossians 2 and 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit.
And our people are spoiled. We're spoiled in our own thoughts because we got wrapped up in the philosophy and the vain deceits of this world. You know?
After the tradition of men.
Because they are traditions of men of the other nations. Go ahead.
After the rudiments of the world,
after the rudiments or the roots of this world,
and not after Christ.
It has nothing to do with Jesus Christ, the black Messiah. Not the white one, because there is no white Messiah. Did you know that, sister? Did you know that Christ is a black man according to the Bible? You know Christ is black, right? I'm gonna prove that in a moment. Go back.
Second Corinthians.
Who said that?
Señora. Second Corinthians chapter 10.
You know I always do that. I'm learning. Go ahead.
Second Corinthians chapter 10 verse 5. Casting down imagination and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God.
You heard that, brother? You heard what it said? There we go. Come here. What's your name, bro? Yeah. I can't hear you, bro.
Nas?
I
like you out. Second Corinthians chapter 10, verse 5.
Listen to this, bro.
Casting down imagination.
Let me ask you a question. You listen to the music right now? You put it on pause, right? You can always bring it back? Can you always bring it back? You can't bring this back, right? So listen to this. This is a lot more important. Go ahead.
Casting down imagination.
That's our job. Brothers, sisters, we're here to cast down imagination. Because a lot of people are under the imagination that Christ is white. Did you know that? Did you know that it's an imagination that Jesus Christ is white? Did you know that Christ is black? Right? We not?
Casting down imagination.
So we're here to cast down that imagination. Go ahead.
And every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God.
We done?
And bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
So we have to come to the obedience of Jesus Christ. You understand, sisters, brother? We're here to bring you into the obedience of Christ. You understand? We must keep these commandments or else we are going to be destroyed. You understand? These are things that your church, your Baptist church, your Catholic church, they're not going to teach you. You understand? Go to Psalms 35 and 28. Watch this.
What do you feel about that?
What
do you feel about that?
Well,
I feel about what? The one that's
black girl
right there.
Which one? She's wicked as hell. Oh, that one, she's wicked as hell. And she's gonna get death if she don't repent and keep the commandments. You understand? Now let me ask you a question. What do you think about you? What are you gonna do to serve God? Because you're gonna get the same death that she's gonna get if you don't get yourself, right? Read that.
Yes. So, chapter 35, verse 28. My tongue shall speak thy righteousness.
Because your tongue, listen, your tongue's supposed to be speaking righteousness. Rather than pointing out behinds, you got one finger pointing at a pair of butt cheeks, but you got four other fingers pointing back at you. What do you got to do to get yourself right? Don't worry about her. You right here. That's lust. You're not worried about saving her soul. You're just worried about how you're gonna get into them jeans. That's what you're worried about. What do you think about that, brother? Damn, she got a nice one. That's what's on your mind. You laughing because you know it's true. Read that.
And thy tongue speak thy righteousness.
You're supposed to be speaking righteousness like us. Why don't you come over here and why don't you learn so that you can correct the system like how we're going to do. Rather than just looking at a pair of cheeks. The way my brother always says, cold cheeks. Go ahead.
And of thy praises all the day long.
We gotta do this all the day long, bro. When you wake up, when you go to sleep, scriptures. Tomorrow, guess what's on the menu? Scriptures. You understand? Every day scriptures, bro, to get yourself right. Rather than looking at a pair of cheeks. Come on, bro. Get yourself right before you start correcting people. And with that, we say shalom.
For many years, brothers and sisters have inquired of us about the haters of Israel United in Christ. I explained to Deacon Asaph, who's one of the best rappers in the world, believe it, that we needed a video. So I gave him my concept, the message I wanted to convey to the people. I had many producers on standby. We also have one of the best video production artist named Bezalel. He's like the Incredible Hulk of all videos, to mold a video around the music that Deacon Asaph will come with and make it happen.
How many times must we check these fools, correct these fools, dissect these fools? They still running their mouth, that's why nobody don't respect these fools.
I heard the song, I loved it, and they made it happen. I wanted to deal with the scoffers first, because there are many haters against the Bible, against God, against Israel, not against Christ. And I want all you at home, brothers and sisters, to understand that the primary focus of Israel United in Christ is to teach you your nationality, the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God. Towards the end of the video, I want all the viewers to understand that we are building a nation of kings and priests according to the scriptures, and we will not be deterred by anyone.
Our wives and our children, if you ain't rolling with us, better get up out the way, cause the God that we walking with is not the one to play.